dandy, whatever this thing is. And when we come to something, it'll tell us. And when we get to where she'll say something, I will play it and we'll hear it. Very much a tourist trap, that is for sure. They really do. They just think, really? You're going to Stonehenge? Go to Avebury. It's a whole lot better. Avebury. That's how they say it. They say it with like the English accent of Avebury. You want to go there. It's much better. And it's free. I don't think I have an English accent very well. Let's see. Are we starting to have anything yet? All right, we'll keep going. There must be something, because they're stopping and listening.
There is no commentary for this number.
Okay, we keep getting there is no commentary for this number. Oh! Nothing.
Stonehenge is a unique prehistoric temple aligned with the movements of the sun. Built in stages between 3000 and 2200 BC, it's the only stone circle in the world to have lintels, the horizontal stones sitting on top of the uprights. Its architecture reveals the sophisticated minds and engineering ability of those who built it, the late Neolithic people of Britain. On this tour, we'll not only find out about Stonehenge, but also the history of the landscape around it. Stonehenge was the centre of a ritual landscape that included prehistoric monuments and burial mounds dating from before, during, and after Stonehenge was built. While our visit will take you close to the stones, we won't be entering the circle itself. That's because the archaeology below the grass is very fragile. Too much foot traffic causes erosion and damage. The information you'll hear today is based upon years of scientific research, yet some mysteries about Stonehenge remain. We still don't know why it was built, or exactly how it was used, but we'll hear some different theories so you can decide for yourself. Now, let's step into the story of Stonehenge. Just move along the path that turns off to the left until you find stop 2. When you get there, key in 2 on your player.
Ready, honey?
Originally, the entire circle would have been chalk white. When the decimated human remains. An estimated 150 people were buried here between about 3000 and 2800 BC. So in its earliest phase, Stonehenge was a cemetery. Just before the bridge, you might be able to see a stone lying flat on the ground. This is the Slaughter Stone. If you want to hear more about it, enter 21. To carry on with your tour, just continue until you reach stop 3.
Inside the stone circle, facing the avenue on Midsummer's Day, or summer solstice, you'd see the sun rise over the Healstone. Similarly, if you were standing by the Healstone on Midwinter's Day, or winter solstice, you'd watch the sun set to the left of the tallest upright with the bump, or tenon on top. It once had a partner stone and a horizontal lintel that, together, would have framed the sunset. As you cross the bridge, you may have spotted an arrow on the ground. This marks the line of the solstice. Stonehenge's alignment shows that its builders had a sophisticated understanding of the sky. The seasons would have been very important to these prehistoric people. The winter would have been a difficult time. They needed the return of longer days and warmth to grow their crops and feed their animals.
You should
Perhaps
be on number
Stonehenge
three.
Stonehenge was a sort of calendar, or a place where the seasons were celebrated. While you're in this area, you might want to hear about the people who built Stonehenge. Theory about Stonehenge's purpose, or about the station stones. To hear about who built Stonehenge, enter 31. To hear why Stonehenge might have been the domain of the ancestors, enter 32. And to hear about the station stones, enter 33.
Okay, I don't know. I was holding the speaker thing and the phone, trying to at the same time film and walk. I don't know if I made you sick trying to watch this. It's not an easy task right now because I'm kind of walking sideways looking at it, and it just makes it weird to film. I've already been to three. Marker stone that they were talking about. Right there. sorry about the wind. Trying to adjust my film and I'm trying to back it out. still or not. I cannot get it to... do what I want. So, okay, this is going to be a part two then.